it's overwhelming, because the whole thing about him is that he finds the world overwhelming. What becomes specifically tricky about playing many characters is when you have to transition from one end to the other, on camera, in front of the audience, and not do it seamlessly, because there is definitely a seam, but there's not a cut. But what was great when I got the script for Glass Through was that it was taking the kind of super people, superhero, super villain archetype and putting them in a very, very different kind of movie. And I think that's exciting. If we're going to keep having superheroes on screen, you've got to put them in different environments and situations. And this film certainly does that. Samuel Jackson has got, I don't know, man, I think he is like uber professional, uber pro, like knows how to have fun all day long and show up and do it at the same time. I don't know, I love being on set with that guy. People always say he's really cool, don't they? People always go like, he's the coolest guy in Hollywood and all that stuff. And he is really cool, but he's also, I like his professionalism as well. Bruce is like the most chilled dude I've ever met in my life. He is so relaxed, but he's bringing such a heaviness to the part. He actually says in one of these scenes that his character doing the super thing that he does leaves him with a heaviness.
Hey there, here's a cool behind the scenes movie fact. Now, for the movie Interview with a Vampire, the actors who played vampires had to hang upside down for 30 minutes in order to get the blood vessels in their face to bulge. Makeup artists would then trace them to get the translucent skin look. Now remember, click here below to subscribe, or over here for more great content.